The next speaker is Jaime Alvarez and Eriko Hara from Takushoku University Graduate School of Engineering, Japan. I'm sorry if I mispronounce. I'm really sorry. My apologies for my pronunciation.
And it's okay. It was fine.
So the paper is titled Robots and Children. Development of a robot for emotional support of children during walking rehabilitation. Yeah.
Okay. Then first let me introduce myself. My name is Jaime. It is pronounced as Jaime. Actually, I work in Japan, but I am Mexican. So it's a Spanish pronunciation, Jaime. And I work together with Mrs. Eriko Hara. She is also participating, however, I'm the one who will do the presentation here. Let me go ahead. I'm going to be the presenter, but anyway, please let me share a short video of my graduate student, Mrs. Hara. Okay, here we go.
Hello, everyone.
Yeah. Now it's okay?
I'm Eriko Hara, a graduate student at Takushoku
University. Now we can hear you.
Now in Japan, it's at night. Today, my research advisor, Professor Jaime Alvarez, will be in charge of the presentation of the research work. The title of the presentation is The Development of a Robot for Emotional Support of Children During Walking Rehabilitation. The robot was developed in collaboration with other departments, and I was in charge of defining the robot design and motion. I hope you find our research interesting and insightful. Thank you very much.
Okay, this was a short presentation, and first of all, let me show you the present state of the robot with another short video. Okay, here we go. Okay, so then let me go through the rest of the presentation. First of all, well, you know that Japan is a country that has a problem of declining birth rate and aging population. And because of this, there is a shortage of care personnel. And actually presently, there is a high demand of caregivers from caregivers professionals from Philippines, Vietnam, from countries all around Japan. Also, there is a concern about the quality of care services, and more recently, of course, there is a COVID situation. So because of this, there is a strong will of the Japanese government to introduce care robots in the country. The purpose of robots that gave care is to reduce the physical burden of the care personnel, also to solve this shortage of professionals in the care area. And in order to do that, there are several robots presently in the market. This is a positioning mapping of from existing robots in the market. We divided them by their function. On the right, we have rehabilitation-related robots, especially for the physiological point of view. In the left side, we have some robots for emotional support. On this above area, we have some robots, but they're used on the care industry, but not for rehabilitation. In this dotted line, we are grouping some walking rehabilitation robots. They are used especially for walking rehabilitation. And we have some exoskeletons, like power suits like this one, or some robots who help people to get the proper posture and balance, and also some robots who provide guidance for walking. And then on the other side, there are some emotional support robots in the market, but they are not used in the rehabilitation industry. They are mainly used for people to deal with some issues like depression or for some cognitive problems for the elderly. And of course, also for some for children who have autism. So then the purpose of this research was explaining the research in a very general way to design, to build, and to validate an autonomous walking robot for emotional support. In order to do that, we made a research about the walking rehabilitation process. Of course, there are several type of rehabilitation process. There are several type of treatments. So we came out with this very general outline of rehabilitation process composed by preparation. Then a second step we called immediately before starting, and then the rehabilitation itself, and then the end of the therapy. By interviewing some rehabilitation professionals, we came out with the emotions, that the emotional state of children during this rehabilitation therapy. We divided this emotion by positive emotions and negative emotions. So based on those emotions, we proposed some robot emotional functions to deal with each of the emotions present in every step. Well, talking about the concept, at this moment, when we came out with this concept, we were thinking about, we are still working on in order to get robot with a high level of autonomy. That means that having a lot of sensors and some level of intelligence. However, at this moment, the robot is operated by remote control because we are in a initial stage of the research. But it is proposed that the robot can actually use some emotion recognizing technology to detect the children emotions, and then to decide by itself how which kind of motion to perform in order to provide this emotional support. Also, we are also thinking about providing this emotional support by adding to the robot some voice or maybe some melody, but at this moment we focus on the movement of the robot, okay? So then we started with the design of the robot with tools like this mood board, looking for inspiration with several shapes, and we came out with this mood board having soft shapes with some harmony, particular relationships between the surface and edge, like tension, dynamism, and also some degree of symmetry. We started the design process by making very rough models. This is a child full-size model. And then creating some storyboards and keep working on physical models, scale models, full-size models. And then based on obtained data, we finally defined the robot dimensions and the robot structure too. The structure of the robot is composed by a head and a torso without limbs. So no legs, no arms. It's a very simple structure. And the dimension of the final prototype are as follows. As you can see, and you also notice in the video from Mrs. Hara, that is kind of small, okay? One special characteristic of this robot is that it has no face. We noticed in our analysis that there are several robots having a face. We started wondering why if we don't use a face. Then after consulting and doing some literature review, we found out that not having a face might have some benefits, like avoiding distractions and avoid misunderstanding with patient, and also to take full advantage of the omni wheel, which means that the omni wheel is a wheel that it can move toward any kind of direction. So if the robot has a face and is like me moving backwards, it may feel like a little bit creepy. And also, we designed the body in order to give some dynamism, especially when the robot is turning. So based on the overall outline of the rehabilitation process, we came out with the, as I explained before, with the emotions of the patient, and then the robot role for to deal with this emotion. So based on that, we decided specific movements of the robot, like the head going slow and down, sliding movement, and rotation that I will show you some videos later. Then we build prototypes. The first one is medium size, like 60 centimeters tall, and it has a different shape because to make it with the original design we proposed, it was very expensive using the high technology 3D printer we have at the university. So we had to make it a little bit more like a squared shape. And then we made a small one robot with more soft and round shape. This one is like this one is smaller, it's 45 centimeters. So this is a comparison between two robots. And then we performed three evaluations for the robots. The first one with a bigger prototype with 20 students in order to evaluate the motion of the robot. At that time, it was just when Corona was starting, so we were able to do some on-site study. But then the two later evaluations were performed by an online survey with students, and then the final one with rehabilitation professionals. In the evaluation of the robot motion, as I explained, there were some 20 students who were able to watch the M-size prototype moving, and they evaluated the movement through using a semantic scale composed of two words, opposite adjectives. Then these are the specific robot motions. The robot was moving in this way through every depending of the movement, and the question was moving like this way, and the respondent was evaluating the robot. Okay, let me show you the very brief videos of the. These are the results. Here am I summarizing the results of the study. Through this movement, I think you can see this is lower than it actually is, but this movement transmitted a sense of calmness to the respondent. And then, for example, this other one transmitted a sense of excitement. The robot is turning in a kind of high speed way. I'm afraid my computer's memory is saturated, so I don't know if you can see it. Maybe a little bit. And well, we have some other movements. I'm going to see this one because I think we are going to get run out of time. The second evaluation was regarding the form of the robot, okay, by a web survey with more than 70 respondents. We had favorable results. The robot was evaluated with an image of being cute, being gentle, being nice. However, one point is that some people thought that the robot has a face, even it doesn't have one. Some people perceive that having the robot having a face, so this we have to work on that issue. These are comparison of the two robots, and the final evaluation was made by a few persons, but they were medical professionals. They evaluated the smaller robot through a similar evaluation, and they were shown these sort of videos. They were shown this type of videos on the web survey. So they evaluated their impression through watching these videos. Okay. I'm going to the next one. Rotation. And opposite rotation of head and torso. Okay. As a result of this final evaluation, the medical staff evaluated the robots with favorable opinions. They related the robot with adjectives such as good, being mechanical, like it, and gentle, and so on. And they, some people say that it has a unique shape and it may help to call the kids' attention, but at the same time, not having a face. Also, some persons say that it's better to not having a face, but some other persons say that it may be scary because it doesn't have a face. So we have to work on that issue too. All the movements were positively evaluated. Only one slight displacement was considered not to be enough for expressing some empathy with the kid. Then let me go through the final conclusions. That we were able to materialize, to build actually two prototypes of the robot, evaluated and evaluate them. Then the robot obtained good results in the three evaluations. They were not associated to negative impressions. And professional staff, medical staff say that it has possibilities to be used for working rehabilitation, which was a very, very valuable feedback for us. However, due to the corona situation, we were not able to test this robot use with children. So this is a very, very big issue that we still need to work on. Even we evaluated with adults and medical staff, and we got positive results. At this moment, we still need to evaluate it with children and to see how they perceive the robot shape and their movements. These are my reference, and this is the end of my presentation. Thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Jaime. It was a very nice presentation and very good info on assisting our robots. So while we are waiting for the questions from the audience, so can I ask some questions? So what does this robot do? It just moves around and or it releases some kind of an expression, or what are the activity it does to comfort you?
Okay, thank you for your question. At this moment, the project has a initial starting point with the design department. So we were in charge of this, of designing the overall concept of the robot. Then the next step was to design the motion of the robot. So for that purpose, the Department of Mechanical System was involved with us. They created the mechanism. We designed and built the body. But then we started testing the movements. We have been planning to incorporate as a next step the electronic system department, and they will add some sensors for, as you can see in this picture, in the in the bottom of the robot, there are a few holes. They are made for to incorporate some sensors in order to avoid collision, in order to also to measure distance and whatever. And we are also planning to incorporate voice, where we are at this moment. We want to clarify the effectiveness of the robot, focus on the movements. And then if we have some success with the movements, we will go through the next step, which will be thinking about specific sound issues, which may be voice or may be like kind of some melodies or some special patterns of melodies for the robot, but at this time it's considered as a next step.
That's very interesting. So I'm hoping that the AI will play a major role in, it must be a self-learning robot, once you have it.
as you said, the artificial intelligence is the technology is evolving in a kind of scary speed. Is improving very quickly. So we are thinking about incorporating some automated emotion recognition technology by adding some sensors and cameras. And actually, to add in a camera will be an issue because we will have to find a way to incorporate a camera that won't look as an eye, you know, as a face feature. So maybe we have to put the camera in the body, not in the head.
Right. Because you purposefully don't want to make it look like a head and like any animal features or you purposely don't want to make it look like a living being, right?
Well, somehow up to some point, because of course if the robot has a torso and has a head, then you may understand it as a living being. And maybe we think that that's another reason why some people thought that the robot has a face. Even that there is no explicit face, there is a head. So maybe if you have a head, then somehow you unconsciously you expect a face. So we need to do some further research on that specific point.
Right. Yeah, true. Again, even the shape also has something to do with, like your visualization looks like an alien or a very living being look. You know? I remember sometime before, in the market, there was this, I think, some kind of ornaments which is available, which respond, changes color according to your change in emotion. You know, there was something like that was available in the market. So.
Actually, that is related. There's another situation related with this robot. I forgot to talk about the background of the research. You know that Japan is a country of robots. So people, they're really used to having robots anywhere, small one like a toy robot or real robots. So that's one situation that we must take advantage with this project.
Okay. So we have not received any questions so far from the audience. So I think, we are well, I think we have overshot the time a little bit. So I would like to thank you both for making this nice presentation. And I also would like to thank all the other presenters who are here. And I think all four presentations were very nice and very, very informative. And the kind of variety of subjects which you all have presented are very impressive. I'm sure all the participants enjoyed the sessions. We, as much as I enjoyed listening to all of you. And thank you very much for presenting. Thank you so much.